In this video, I'll be showing you the most underrated technique in creating realistic 3D animations. Rendering a series of animations can take time, especially when you're rushing for a deadline, and we don't actually know what's going to happen with our computer after we hit the render button. There's always a small chance that your computer could crash or shut down due to power outage. And the worst part is, your rendering video file suddenly doesn't work. You could be wasting a lot of hours or even days waiting and potentially losing a valuable client or project. The good news is, you're about to learn how you can avoid this kind of mishap. I will also be sharing with you one simple yet effective technique that could literally save you tons of post-production hours. So make sure to watch till the end of this video. Okay, here's what you'll need. D5 Render, Lightroom, and After Effects. We're going to be using image sequences in D5 Render, so let's get into it. Let's go to D5 Render's website. Go to the Assets Navigation tab and select Free 3D Asset Scene Download. All of these are free for you to test out and explore. Today, we'll be testing out this city scene right here. Click on the download link, which will then redirect you to WeTransfer. Click the download button and unzip the file. Let's open up the D5 render file. You might receive a warning about incompatible assets. All you have to do is just select the update all option. To create an animation, select the second camera icon. Make an animation sequence by assigning two reference points. Now here's the trick. Click on the sequence tab. Leave it as PNG for now, change the output resolution to 4K, and select which channels you want. But in this instance, let's just turn everything off. And then, click on the render button. The benefit of rendering your animation this way is that it gives you the ability to progressively save every single image frame by frame. And if suddenly an error comes up, you won't lose any of your rendered data, which could potentially save you your time and effort. Once you're done with your rendering, go ahead and open up Lightroom. Here, we can do some post-production editing. First, create an album, give it a name, and click on Add Photos. Select all image files and choose Review for Import. On the upper right corner of your screen, choose Select All and then click on Add Photos. Let's start editing our first image. Now what's great about this process is that after we're done with our first edit, we can just copy all of our edit settings and apply it to the rest of the files. It's basically doing batch editing. Thank you. Once done, export them all together into one folder. Now there's a bunch of software you can use to do this next step, but for this tutorial, we're going to be using After Effects. So click on the File tab, New, and then New Project. Let's start importing our images into After Effects. Click on File, Import, and then File. Select the first image, make sure to tick the PNG sequence and create Composition Box Options. Then click Import. Next, press the spacebar on your keyboard to have a quick preview. To export our animation file, go to File, Export, and choose Media Encoder Queue. Let's tweak some settings. Once you're ready, hit the green play button and wait for it to finish. Let's have a look at the final result. Great! Now check out more tips and tricks by clicking on the next video right here.